Bad behaviour brings shame on everybody. First to feel Sanjeev's wrath is Ankita.
We decided this thing, that they will go to your class, then you have some responsibility towards them.
I seriously didn't know where they were going, and they never told me.
When they were going out, you should have accompanied them.
No, but
I have told you.
They had taken ma'am's permission.
I have told you that you have some responsibility towards them.
Papa!
Till they are in the school, they are your responsibility. Tomorrow they may fight with somebody and you will sit in your class? Is this your responsibility? You just leave them in the school and you enjoy yourself with all your friends. Forget about that you have two brothers, sisters. Don't show this kind of behavior. Those two children, they don't understand this. There they don't have this kind of discipline.
I told them they're not allowed to bunk classes.
Today whatever has happened has happened. Am I clear? From tomorrow onward, act like a shadow. Don't let them go out of your eyes. Am I clear? No further arguments on this aspect. Now go and change. Come down.
I found it very bad and very embarrassing about my reputation. It's just because of them, because of their actions. First time I've been scolded because of someone else's fault.
Josh and Charlotte finally arrive back home. The whole family is waiting for them, but it's Sanjeev they'll need to face.
This grey card has been given because of bunking class, going out of campus without permission. Who suggested amongst both of you that let's go out?
We both decided it was kind of, we wanted to go and get a drink.
So you couldn't get a drink in the canteen?
We wanted food, we wanted to just get out of the school.
Because you got bored? And suppose if you don't go to the school and stay in the at home for the entire day, you will get more bored here.
I appreciate it, yeah. But do you think, yeah?
No, it's not appreciating. See, let us be very clear. I'm a very, very clear man. This is a very big embarrassment to me, to the principal, whom I had taken a special permission. For your information, before you had come down here, I spent the entire day talking out that yes, allow these two kids to stay with you in the school. I said I want that they should understand what is an Indian school. So please, and you promise me this, nothing of this kind will happen tomorrow. Second thing, both of you will not sit together in the class. Sit differently. See, you have come here to meet Indians. You are not meant for 7 days to stay together. This line is very clear, should be understood. If you're not understanding, sorry. I have a very different way of treating you then. I'm a very good friend if you are good friends with us. Am I clear? Any questions? Any problems?
We've apologised. It's the end of it, really. Yeah, we've said we're sorry. We literally can't do much more than that.
Like, they just made it perfectly clear that they just don't understand that we wanted to be by ourselves. It gets too much after a while, living under their roof and being with them at school, and then coming home and eating with them as a family, and then going to sleep with them, and it's literally just constantly 24/7 they're in your face all the time, and there is no way you can escape from it.